simple musician. I can't name all the chords and play millions of scales, but I really love and enjoy playing every note, even if it's just one chord. I really feel it, you see. I would say a mark of a good musician is if you can play one note and mean it. It's better than being able to play zillions of scales and not mean it. The first piece is called Guilty, and my fourth album, which was called Incantations, was all based around one chord, which was sort of like this. And I wanted to do an up-tempo piece of music using that chord, so that it was a traditional bass, drums, guitar, piano, rhythm section, but using a more interesting chord to base it on, rather than sort of the usual sorts of formulas that people use to do that sort of music. I started off in music playing acoustic guitar like this and finger picking, and I've developed that style with my nails, and I've continued that over to electric. Well, I can best show you on the electric, really. There's certain sections where I need to have a pick to play normal. You see? And then I have to quickly put the pick up to my mouth like that. For when I use the sustain sound, because I have to stop every string that's not being sounded, otherwise it makes this sort of noise. And so I pick it like a classical guitar. And I'm either stopping them here with my nails there, or stopping it up here somehow. So you can see all the others have stopped, you see. I can do it with any guitar. Well, the beginning of Tubular Bells is it's like a formula, you know. Sort of, you just hammer in between one string and another. In fact, I did it on piano. And that formula has been ripped off so often by films and TV commercials that I thought, well, I'll rip myself off and start doing some different ones. So I thought of a different one hammering thing. It's almost the same, but it goes. Instead of. So I put that in just to make it give it a bit of variation. I mean, there's zillions of different ones you can think of. There'd be. You know, we go on endlessly. Well, at Nebworth we started with just acoustic guitar. It was very nice because a lot of it was very loud and had drums and bass and all sorts of stuff going on. It was nice to come down quiet and have an acoustic bit. And, you know, I was very worried that it wouldn't work, but it did work. Even in really big places, they had actually listened. Days and when I wrote it, it was quite experimental for me. It had sort of all strange major seven chords and things, more jazz type of chords. And then into a very simple folk melody. And then after that, Nico and the Voices come in and do this sort of very romantic mandolin type guitar bit. And then we go into a guitar solo, which got this figure. And that's a sequence of chords that I've had for ages. That I like soloing on, playing just anything I feel like. So it's complete. That's in fact the only part in the concert where I actually improvise. I make it up as I go along, and then we finish up with this little hornpipe, and we'll jump up and down. Thank you. Well, it begins with a round of voices, which is a very simple folk tune. It's just like a sort of nursery rhyme tune, but if you do it in round form with four voices, it sounds like it was a real accident that I discovered that. So much of it is accident. Also with Omadhon, I get really sort of disappointed the way that bass and drums instantly categorise everything that they used on into a certain format. And so with Omadhon, I thought I'd experiment with other sorts of percussion, and I got a load of percussionists from a group called Jabula to play African drums. They had great big lovely carved drums. I spent the whole day with them and finding out what they did. And ended up with the African drum riff at the end of Omadhon. I used that for a whole thing and built it around that. But it turned into a very emotional thing for me because I was like at a crossroads in my life, and you know, I was living miles out in the country. And since that time, I've gradually become more involved with people and cooperating. And I live near London now, and I'm very involved with working with other people, but Omadhon was done really in a vacuum on my own. And it was very emotional. In fact, the very end of side one of Omadhon is probably the piece I'm most satisfied with. What I wanted to do, I did it as well as I ever have done anything. I'm not saying it's the best thing I've done, but as far as my intention in a certain direction, it was the most efficient realization of what I wanted. know, a big festival like that is very, and it's almost medieval or prehistoric in character. Everybody gets together and just does something. It just happens to be music, you know. So I don't see it as I mean, the whole festival is like a piece of music or a painting. It's just a different celebration of probably the same thing, the fact that we're, most of us are quite glad to be alive, glad to be here.